Okay, so first we have to find the stationary points, which means we gotta derive this equation. Okay, then we have to make this equal to zero. And then we have to factor it. Over here, we're going to use the man method. And now we get our solutions, which are the stationary points. Once we get our stationary points, remember we put them on our number line. We test out each range. Over here, all we care about is whether these values are positive or negative. I'll put them in my calculator. That's a negative. That is a positive. So we know that a function is increasing, then decreasing, and then increasing again. So in this function here, we have a maximum and we have a minimum that we will have to find out later as well. Or we can just do that now. So our minimum is at 3, comma, and then we substitute this value in the original equation. Okay, so our mins and maxes are two things we need to know for our sketches. So make sure you circle that. Okay, next we gotta do the intervals of concave up and concave down. So I'm gonna double derive my equation. Then I'm gonna make this equal to zero. And then I'm gonna solve it. Okay, so we have one inflection point. Remember, we want to put this on our number line as well. I'm going to do y double prime of 0. Y double prime of 3. So we know this is concave down, concave up. We can write our intervals as well now. So intervals of increase on negative infinity. intervals of decrease are intervals of concave up and then concave down. So those are intervals that finally we can do our inflection point. Inflection point is 2, 3. Once we have our inflection points and our mins and our maxes, we can sketch our graph. First thing I'm going to do is put my min 3, 1 is my min. Okay, then I'm going to put my max, which is 1, 5. Okay, and then I'm going to mark my inflection point as well in between. So we have a min, a max, and we have an inflection point. So the easiest thing to do is draw the max out like that. And switch the direction there. Then turn that into a min.